Don't play the guitar while you're out there. He's not nervous. There you go. The Tour of Victoria, we are so glad to be teaming up with everybody from the Tour of Victoria. Great event. We have extra bike racks here today. This is an event we really want to see grow. An event we really want to help Tour of Victoria become even bigger in this community. They do an amazing job. And I think they have a lot of symbiosis between the HarbourCats, what we do, and what Tour of Victoria does. And we're certainly pleased to be attached to it and working with Ryder. Great pitch, buddy. Appreciate it, my friend. Thank you. Ryder Hedgehog, everybody. Now, today's also a very fun day for us. It's a chance to recognize some players that have really given a lot to our organization. So many guys could be recognized. It's always tough to get down to a few. But today, I'd like if you and the fans would really help us along with this process here today. These guys have given us summers to develop in the game of baseball. Their school sent them here to get better and to work on their game. And we're glad to provide them a tremendous atmosphere. Thanks to you folks. Thanks to our corporate sponsors. Thanks to our staff and volunteers that allow us to be able to put a pro-style environment here for these players. That many of them will go away from here. There's some of them leave here. This is the best experience in their lives in baseball. There's others who have won other greater things. As we've seen with Nick Pavetta, Alex Pagoni, Nathan Lucas, other guys like that have made their way up the chain. I think they have 29 professional baseball players right now that have come through the HarbourCats. A pretty cool number. When you put that number up against anybody, we're pretty proud of that number. So we do have some awards to go today, but I want to ask some special people. I want to ask our head coach, Todd Haney, done an amazing job this year. Help me welcome him out to make a presentation. Coach, great job. I'm sorry you can't win every year. I know you want to. I'd also like to welcome out two of our ownership group. I'd like to welcome out Gwen Harder, and I'd like to welcome out Karen Swanson. If they would come on out and help these presentations make these good. You see them around the park. They love being a part of this, and it's a lot of fun to do this. The first award we'd like to give out is brought to you by Bayview Place, and it is the Community Player of the Year Award.
Oh, other one?
Good job here, Christian.
The Community Player of the Year award, this is the guy who spent 2 years here with us. He's played 38 games with us as a HarbourCat last year, 39 as of today, for a total of 77 games. He's been a team leader. He's also a heck of a dancer on the bus, I might add. Been a defensive stalwart this year, hitting 284 with 11 doubles and 6 home runs for 8 home runs total as a HarbourCat. Not a bad pitching line, but he had a chance to do it as well over this last week. He's been a tremendous ambassador for the program both here and when he's at his school, when he's back home, when he's back at Cal Baptist. You know what? A great player, but an even better person. We want to congratulate our Community Player of the Year award is to Harrison Swan. It's photo op day, folks. We really enjoy doing this. Harrison, you remember on the plaque and on a photo in our office forever, and we appreciate everything you've done for us. Congratulations to Harrison Swan. We had some very difficult choices when it came to the pitcher of the year, so we kind of took the easy route and decided to go with two different guys. One is the
Sunday afternoon baseball from Wilson's Group Stadium at Royal Athletic Park. It's the final day of the 2019 West Coast League regular season as the Victoria HarbourCats take on the Port Angeles Lefties. Hi, everyone, and thanks for tuning in on Go Live Broadcast and Shaw Spotlight. My name is Mike Edwards, along with producer Chris Jaycox in the broadcast truck. Well, with it being the final day of the regular season, the HarbourCats here at home at Wilson's Group Stadium giving out their season end awards. That is happening as we speak at on the field. So we will join the pregame awards ceremony. Then we'll have the anthems and the first pitch. After that, HarbourCats and the Lefties coming right up here on Shaw Spotlight and Go Live broadcasts.
And this season with maybe the most appearances on the team as well. It's our second home pitcher of the year from Pomona. Pitcher last year was Yoshihara. He did a great job for us. Congratulations to Luca Green. From UT San Antonio, let's welcome off Griffin Paxton, Player of the Year.
Now you can't go over to that. Do you have a play ball kit?
Sorry.
Oh, Jim.
Where do you want?
Yeah, welcome to the office. Okay. Do you get anything there? Thank you.
I can hold on to that stuff if you want.
This is Benjamin.
Ready? Okay. You got your fire.
Put him in here. And I'll sit beside you and protect you.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we would ask that you please rise and remove your caps for the playing of the national anthems brought to you today by Carol Engineering and presented by Josh Boudreau.
After the pregame festivities, the HarbourCats Awards ceremony, and the national anthems. We are set for baseball here on this Sunday afternoon. A little bit of a later start, but that's all right. HarbourCats and the Lefties closing out their respective 2019 regular seasons. Well, the season has come and gone in the blink of an eye. 54 games from the start of June to today here in early August. And the HarbourCats play one more regular season game today before they begin the postseason with the North Division Series starting on Tuesday night in Wenatchee. And for the Lefties, who will not be going to the postseason, it's one more chance for them to take the field here in 2019, and they will hope to end it on a high note before they all head back to their respective colleges for the fall. Well, here's a look at the game time weather before first pitch on this Sunday afternoon in Victoria. 18 degrees Celsius, 65 degrees Fahrenheit, partly cloudy skies, and just a little bit of wind right now blowing out to left field. The winds did seem to be a factor yesterday. It was blowing out towards left center field, and it might have helped a handful of the balls that were hit in the air, because we had 8 home runs in yesterday's game, 6 for the HarbourCats. And the wind, I think, did play a little bit of a factor. HarbourCats take the field in their all-white home uniforms. They are led out by Zach Swanson for Victoria. Swanson makes his first start of the summer. He stands at 6'1", 167 pounds, goes to San Diego Christian University, and he is a rising sophomore there with the San Diego Christian Hawks. Native of Victoria, BC, and a graduate of Lambert Park Secondary School. Of course, he is the son of HarbourCats GM and managing partner, Jim Swanson. And so Zach Swanson gets the ball for today's season finale. He has appeared in 5 games so far this summer, both as a pitcher and as a position player. This is his second appearance as a pitcher, although he has also thrown in a number of the HarbourCats non-league games. So we have seen him now and then on the season, and he will get his first West Coast League start here this afternoon. Lineup for Port Angeles looks like this here today. Gavin Rourke, the center fielder, leads off. Trevor Rosenberg will bat second, and he is at shortstop. Reese DeHeiden, the left fielder, bats third. Brad Altamari, the second baseman, bats in the cleanup spot for Port Angeles. The catcher, Tommy Takeyoshi, bats fifth. Riley Quinton, the third baseman, is sixth. Dylan Sear in right field bats seventh. Brandon Soloka, who homered yesterday, one of the two lefties' home runs, he bats eighth at first base. And Carson Jackson, the DH, rounds out the Port Angeles order in the number 9 spot. So set to get underway here on this Sunday afternoon. 54 games, and they'll all be in the books after this one is complete here on this Sunday. 53 down, 1 to go for the HarbourCats, and Zach Swanson's first pitch missed for 1 ball and no strikes to Gavin Rourke, and we are officially underway here. A little bit of a late start. We thank you for sticking with us here on Shaw Spotlight and Go Live broadcast with the pregame award ceremony. Ball and a strike here on Gavin Rourke. He was in the leadoff spot yesterday when 0 for 3 did draw a walk. Overall in the season, he's hitting .303 with 1 home run and 10 RBIs. Also has stolen 24 bases, which is second in the West Coast League. And, of course, first on the lefties. 2 balls and a strike now to Rourke. After him, Rosenberg, and then Reese DeHeiden, the three who will hit for the lefties in this top of the first inning. Now the 2-1 pitch from Swanson is a strike on the outer half of the plate. It's 2-2. Well, it was fireworks night last night, so we had a big crowd at the yard, over 4,000 fans. Looks like a decent crowd as well here today, despite the fact that it's a bit of a cloudy afternoon. Final day of the regular season in the West Coast League. Pitch was a breaking ball there from Swanson that missed above the zone. And it's a full count, 3-2 on Gavin Rourke. Now here comes the payoff pitch from Swanson. It's a swing and a miss. Got him on strikes for the first out. And that's how this afternoon's game gets underway, with a strikeout for Zach Swanson. And that starts the first inning. Well, here is now the defense for the HarbourCats today. Left to right in the outfield, Ty Schindel, Nick Playa, Kyle Sherrick. Harrison Spahn is at third base. Gus Wilson at short, Tanner Haney at second. Griffin Paxton at first. McGregor Sharp is behind the plate doing the catching for Zach Swanson. This is Trevor Rosenberg. Took ball one, and now he'll take ball two off the plate outside. 2-0 count. Rosenberg hitting 222 coming into today. 13 runs driven in for him on the season. Yesterday, took an 0-for-4 with a strikeout at the plate. Pops this one up foul, and it's now 2-1. Umpires for today's game, we have a three-man crew once again. John Hollett is behind home plate, calling the balls and strikes. Scott Eckhart is at first, and Sean Sullivan right now is at third. He will be roaming around between second and third with the three-man umpiring crew. Pop up on the infield. Griffin Paxton coming in from first base. He will put it away, and there's two down. Well, I mentioned HarbourCats giving out their end-of-season awards before the game. We'll talk more about that with Jim Swanson when he comes to the booth for inning number 5 later in the game. But just to recap it for you, Griffin Paxton named the HarbourCats Player of the Year. HarbourCats also announced co-pitchers of the year, Dakota Hawkins and Luca Green out of the bullpen. This one is a pop-up back out of play foul. No balls and one strike on Reese DeHeiden. Last two awards that were given out, the Community Player of the Year, Harrison Spahn, a returning player who's really been a fan favorite in his 2 years here in Victoria. And then the last one, not so much an award, but in the Ring of Honor, the HarbourCats have inducted fan favorite Nick Playa, another returning player from Cal Baptist, who has been a great HarbourCat for 2 seasons. And he joins some of the HarbourCat greats in their 7 seasons of West Coast League Baseball up in the Ring of Honor here at Wilson's Group Stadium. Liner out to right field. This is going to be put away by Kyle Sherrick, and that's all for the lefties in the first. Nice 1-2-3 frame for Zach Swanson, and we head on to the bottom half. HarbourCats and the lefties scoreless on Shaw Spotlight and Go Live broadcasts. To the bottom of the first inning, and Nick Playa will step in to lead it off for the HarbourCats. Fresh into the Ring of Honor for Victoria. He fouls one away there on the first pitch from Joe Kinski, the right-hander from Denver, Colorado and Santa Barbara Community College. He stands at 6 feet, 190 pounds. He makes his fourth start of the summer and his sixth appearance in total. And he's been quite good for Port Angeles on the season. 0-1 pitch is a swing and a miss by Playa. Nothing and two now the count. But Kinski, 2-1 with a 3.27 ERA. He's allowed just 7 hits in 22 innings. The issue, though, for him is that he's also allowed 19 walks in 22 innings, along with 12 strikeouts. 0-2 to Playa downstairs. It's 1-2. Again, Kinski has been good overall on the season, but he is coming off of a bad last start on August the 5th against Corvallis. He went 5 2/3, allowed 7 runs, 6 of them earned on 4 hits and 10 walks. Playa rolls one towards the hole. Rosenberg at deep short, the jump throw not in time. And Playa has an infield hit. That ball is just perfectly placed on the infield towards the hole between third and short. When Rosenberg got to it, there was never going to be a chance for him to make a play on it. So Playa reaches base. He's been hot at the plate recently. Comes into today at 273, 6 home runs, 27 RBIs. Another guy who's been hot is now coming to the plate, Gus Wilson. He enters play at 381. There is a first pitch strike to Wilson, and it's nothing and one to start out this at bat for Kinski. Well, Wilson hitting again 381, 5 RBIs for him in just a short time with the HarbourCats. He's really impressed since he joined the team. There goes Playa for second, but it's a swing and a foul towards the Port Angeles dugout by Gus Wilson. No balls, 2 strikes. Playa is going to be forced to go back to first base. Well, the rest of the HarbourCats order this afternoon looks like this. Playa and Wilson, the first two, then Griffin Paxton, who was just named the HarbourCats Player of the Year before the game. He bats third. Tyson Hayes, the DH, is in the cleanup spot here this afternoon. Wilson goes upstairs and pops it up. At second base, Brad Altamari sees it into his glove, and that'll be the first out of the bottom of the first inning. After Hayes, it'll be Harrison Spahn, the third baseman, batting fifth. Kyle Sherrick, the right fielder, batting sixth. Tanner Haney, the second baseman, bats seventh. Ty Schindel in left field bats eighth. And McGregor Sharp rounds out the order in the number 9 spot for Todd Haney today. So one on and one out now for Victoria. Playa at first. Griffin Paxton stepping in. Hit 2 more home runs yesterday. Paxton started to go, but then, or I should say Playa started to go at first, but then stopped and went back to the bag. Paxton took it outside off the plate for 1 ball and no strikes. Paxton's really enjoyed playing against the lefties this week. He has 4 home runs on the week, and all those were his first 4 long balls of the summer. Playa was running, and it got to the backstop off the glove of Takeyoshi, so Playa's going to have a stolen base. It's 2-0 now to Paxton. So overall, he comes in hitting 316, 4 home runs, 30 runs driven in, had 3 runs driven in yesterday. Solo home run and a 2-run shot. Also had a 2-homer game earlier this week against the lefties in Port Angeles. And I mentioned it took him a while to hit his first home run of the summer, but they've kind of opened the floodgates for him in terms of the home run swing, because again, he has 4 just this week. But even before that, when he was not hitting home runs, he was still an excellent hitter in the middle of the HarbourCats order, well above 300 all year long. Paxton with a high chopper foul towards first. It's a 3-1 count. Well, Kinski on the mound today for Port Angeles. He has a little bit of pressure on him to go deep into the game because the lefties roster is absolutely decimated when it comes to the pitching staff. They're going to have to have a handful of position players most likely throw today, as they did yesterday. But the longer Kinski goes, the better for the lefties. As they try to end their season on a high note, it's not been a good week for Port Angeles. And 1 more game to go for them. That misses to Paxton for ball four. Playa will advance on the wild pitch. So it's a walk to Paxton. Runners are at the corners for Victoria with one away, and Tyson Hayes steps in.
Number 10, Tyson.
Well, Hayes, another one of the HarbourCats who went deep yesterday as part of a 3-for-4 day at the plate with a solo home run. That was his fifth of the summer. Downstairs below the knees to Tyson Hayes. One ball, no strikes. Hayes and the HarbourCats trying to get right on the lefties here in the first inning, as they have done in each of the first two games of this series. Missing as well, that time to Hayes, 2-0. Kinski, on the other hand, trying to get a ground ball towards the middle of the infield for a potential inning-ending double play. Double play depth up the middle. At first, Brandon Soloka is holding on Paxton at the first base bag. So there is a big hole between first and second for Hayes. If he tries to just punch one the other way into right field, has a lot of room to try to come up with a base hit. It is a 3-0 count. Kinski, we mentioned the issues he's had recently with the walks, trying to avoid back-to-back walks. And the 3-0. There's a strike on the other half of the plate. It's 3-1. 86 on that fastball from Joe Kinski, trying to get right back in the strike zone here and avoid the walk to Tyson Hayes. We'll see, though, if Hayes is swinging away here on 3-1. There goes Paxton. Hayes with a rocket down the left field line, but it goes foul. Had home run distance on it, but it was a fair ways foul. Hayes just could not hold back on that swing. So it's now a 3-2 count. Paxton was also running on the pitch from first. We'll see if he's going to be going again. 3-2, one out. Would stay out of the double play potentially if he does go. There he goes again. Hayes takes outside. It's ball four. So the bases are loaded with one out here in the bottom of the first inning. Harrison Spahn, who was the recipient of the HarbourCats Community Player of the Year award pre-game. So Spahn now stepping in, looking to come up with a big hit and give the HarbourCats an early lead. Spahn also had a good day yesterday with the bat. Went 1-for-4 with a solo home run. That was his sixth long ball of the summer. Nothing and nothing pitch to Spahn is in there at the knees for strike one. Well, there's nowhere to put Spahn, so Kinski needs to be in and around the strike zone in this at bat. He does have to be careful, though, with Spahn at the plate, because he has been red hot the last 3-4 weeks. Seen the average rise up to 284 coming into today. 6 homers, 22 runs driven in. Oh, and one pitch downstairs, 1-1. But Spahn has really had a strong second half, in addition, of course, to playing excellent defense, as he always does, whether it's at short or at third. He's been playing a little more third recently, with Griffin Paxton moving from third to first and Gus Wilson playing short. Foul back over top of the home plate grandstand. 1-2 now on Spahn. Kinski ahead, looking either for a strikeout or, again, a potential double play ball. Playa at third, Paxton at second, Hayes at first. One away, bottom of the first inning. HarbourCats threatening here to take an early lead on the lefties. The 1-2 pitch. Spahn started to go, but held up. Good block as well by Tommy Takeyoshi. There's also a good-looking pitch there from Kinski. Breaking ball that just kind of fell off the table, but Spahn was not fooled by it. So it's an even count now, 2-2. Wind continues to blow out to left field. We had 8 home runs yesterday, 6 by the HarbourCats. This is a rocket right to third. to second one. The relay throw not in time at first, and a run scores. Playa comes in. Spawn will get an RBI fielder's choice. It's 1-0 Hovercats. Well, Spawn hit that ball very hard to third base to Riley Quinton, and he almost had, I think, Quinton to wait a second to make sure he had it before going to second with the throw, and by then it was too late to get Spawn for a double play. So, runners at the corners now, 2 away, 1-0 Harborcats lead. Kyle Sherrick, another one of the Victoria home run hitters yesterday. Sherrick went 1-for-3 with also a walk in addition to the long ball. That'll miss down and away to Sherrick for a ball and no strikes. So Paxton is now. Spawn running on the pitch. The throw from Takayoshi. Back to home plate, and out is Griffin Paxton at the plate. Harborcats tried a double steal, but it did not work. Well played defensively by Port Angeles, and that will end the inning. Harborcats score. Inning number two here at Wilson's Group Stadium. Harborcats with an early 1-0 lead on top of the Port Angeles Lefties as this ball is flown out to straightaway center field. Nick Playa ranges over to it, and he will put it away to get Brad Altamari for the first out. So four up, four down for Zach Swanson to start his afternoon. Been a nice start for him on the hill. 1 away now for the catcher, Tommy Takayoshi. He got the start behind the plate in game one of this series. Day off yesterday with Brandon Soloka behind the dish. Soloka hit a two-run home run in yesterday's game. And now he moves to first base for today's series finale to allow Takayoshi to return behind the plate. Ground ball to Gus Wilson at short. Check that. That's actually Spawn at short. Throw over to first is in time. Harborcats have actually made a defensive change here, so Spawn is at short. Nick Adams is now at third. So Gus Wilson started the game at short, but it looks like he has been lifted. Swanson's first pitch misses down and in there to Riley Quinton, the third baseman.
Does anyone know if we have veteran recognition today?
Quinton yesterday went 3-for-4, drove in a run and scored a run, including a double, so it was a good day for him at the plate individually yesterday. It was a good competitive game between the Harborcats and the Lefties. Again, a lot of excitement with the 8 home runs we saw. Harborcats victorious by a score of 7-4. Chase Stewart picked up the save. But it was a good back-and-forth game. And the type of game that the Lefties want to be in, not the routes that they've been on the wrong side of earlier this week. 1-2 now on Quinton. Now the 1-2 pitch coming up from Zach Swanson. That's a good breaking ball, and it's in there for a called third strike. Quinton down looking, and it's 6 up and 6 down for Zach Swanson through 2 scoreless innings for the Harborcats, and they have a 1-0 lead.
All right, thank you, Ken. Wilson's great finish for the Harborcats. Always great to recognize a serving or retired member of our armed forces. And they just want to serve 35 years in the Army. He served in Afghanistan. He was a serving major for NATO's
Bureau of Deployment Troops, and you can recruit instructors and all that sweet look. Will you please stand and join me in thanking the mail for all of your service to our country.
Draft day.
Johnny Man.
Looks like a good crowd on the zip line tonight. This is your opportunity.
I love this. I get the phone.
Congratulations, Coralie Man. You have won some coffee from the Indian Book to claim your prize.
Back here for the bottom of the second inning, we thank you for sending in your tweets to the broadcast. Remember, use the hashtag HarbourCats. Your tweet could be featured throughout the rest of today's game. Do that a couple more times in the inning breaks. HarbourCats with the 1-0 lead, and Kyle Sherrick at the plate here with a high chopper towards first. Flip to the pitcher Kinski covering the bag for the out, and there's one down to start the bottom of the second inning.
Number 2, Tanner Haney.
Well, here now is Tanner Haney for Victoria. Base is clear, one away. HarbourCats trying to add to the 1-0 lead they have. They did load the bases in the first inning and got a run out of it, but nothing more as Haney takes a strike there from Kinski. Nothing in one. Good breaking ball at 71, catching the strike zone. Haney with a little bloop out to right field. This is going to work. It's a base hit for Tanner Haney. Haney brought a .269 batting average into today with a home run and 14 RBIs, and that is continuing to go up. He's another player for Victoria who has had a productive week at the plate. Went 1-for-2 with a couple of walks yesterday. And now it's Ty Schindel. Schindel went 2-for-4 yesterday. That saw his average rise up to .256 on the season. Also has a home run and 7 RBIs. Breaking ball, or check that, a fastball actually at 85, just down low though to Ty Schindel. One ball, no strikes. Haney at first, one out. HarbourCats have a run on 2 hits. For the HarbourCats, Zach Swanson has not allowed any base runners through the first 2 innings. Fouled away there by Ty Schindel, one ball, one strike. Well, just at the tail end of the last inning, we were talking about the changes the HarbourCats made. I didn't see, personally, from up here in my vantage point in the booth, anything up with Gus Wilson after his at-bat. So we'll hope that he is not injured and that it was just a ordinary change the HarbourCats were making. They sent Spahn from third to short and then brought Nick Adams into the game at third base. Throw goes down to second. Haney's going to be out. Good throw by Takeyoshi to get him stealing. And that'll be the second out of the inning. Schindel now at the plate. And he is now hitting with the bases clear and 2 outs. Kinski behind here on Schindel, 2-1. Schindel sends a high fly ball out to deep left field, going back on it towards the warning track. DeHyde reaches up to make the catch. And that'll retire the side here in the second. 1-0, HarbourCats still lead it as we head on to inning number 3.
This is the Wendy's mascot base race. Today we have Robbie and Sam making their way out there. Alright, quick high five. On your marks, get set, go!
Purchase land to build a new public safety building using provincial gaming revenue from hosting Elements Casino Victoria. The new building has larger sleeping quarters, so volunteer firefighters can be on call, on site, and respond to emergencies even faster. The building isn't only home to the town's fire department, though. It also has space for public safety staff and a secondary emergency operations center, too. BCLC, we're community-minded, with your community in mind.
On to inning number 3 here at Wilson's Group Stadium. HarbourCats with a narrow 1-0 lead as we go now to the third. Zach Swanson back to work. And there's a called strike 1 to the right fielder Dylan Sear. 1-for-3 yesterday for Sear, who enters play with a .257 batting average. Also a home run and 3 RBIs in limited at bats for Sear on the summer. Swanson ahead, 0-2. He's looking very confident on the mound through his first couple frames. 0-2 pitch, in on the hands, popped up into foul ground. Swanson going after it, and he couldn't quite get there. I think Zach Swanson was going to be the only player who had a chance to get there, but no one could get there in the end. Nick Adams, also from third base, hustling over there. It remains 0-2 on Dylan Sear. And another 0-2 pitch coming up in the dirt that time. Now 1-2. Well, we thank you for tuning in here on Shaw Spotlight and Go Live broadcast this afternoon. Final game of the regular season for the HarbourCats. We will have the game 2 of the division series as Sear strikes out, waving a miss at a good breaking ball by Swanson, buried down and in. And there's one away. But again, we will have the game 2 of the division series when the HarbourCats are back home on Go Live broadcast for you Wednesday night, 6:35. We are also just still awaiting confirmation as to whether that game will be on Shaw for our audience on Vancouver Island, but we are hopeful that it will be. But regardless, you can definitely watch the game on Go Live broadcast online, $6.99 a game. And the HarbourCats, we've been with you all summer long, all home games on Go Live broadcasts. We hope that you'll stick with us for the playoffs to watch the HarbourCats in their pursuit of that elusive first West Coast League title. They'll play Wednesday and then, if necessary, Thursday at home after the Tuesday opener in Wenatchee. I should also let you know that I will be in Wenatchee on Tuesday night. We will do a broadcast on Facebook Live on the HarbourCats Facebook page. Now, just a fair warning, will not be the quality, of course, that you're used to on Go Live, and the great job that our producer Chris Jaycox does to really mimic a Major League style broadcast and come as close to that as we do here in the HarbourCats home games. But we will still have a Facebook Live stream with a camera from my vantage point, and you'll hear me calling the game, so you can tune in on Tuesday night to see how game 1 is going. There's the first base runner allowed by Zach Swanson. It's a one-out walk issued to Brandon Soloka. This now is the DH, Carson Jackson. Jackson went deep yesterday in the ball game. He's a Port Angeles kid, just graduated from Port Angeles High School. He's going to Everett Community College. Great moment for him as part of a two-for-four day at the plate yesterday.
Yeah, buddy, go to try.
I think they said Swanson just balked, so they're going to give...
McGregor, we're good.
They're going to give Soloka second base.
We're good.
Swanson looks a little perplexed out there, but home plate umpire John Hollett said that Swanson maybe just shuffled his feet or something. So the first base runner in scoring position now on the ball game for Port Angeles as they try to tie up the game. They have two cracks here with one out to try to get Soloka in from second. It's a nothing and one count on Carson Jackson.
And I got lost in writing and I thought it was... I think that's two late arrivals over the whole season. I think it's not too bad.
Bunt is put down foul towards the first base side. Nothing in two now, the count.
Yes, sir.
No balls, two strikes, one out. Runner at second in the top of the third inning for Port Angeles. Zach Swanson still yet to allow a hit, but working in a little bit of trouble here, just trying to work out of it. Big breaking ball misses up high, 1-2 here on Jackson. Now the 1-2 pitch in the dirt. Good take by Jackson, and it's 2-2. Well, Swanson was in a very good rhythm in the first two innings. He just kind of slowed it down a little bit here as he tries to work around that walk and then the balk that allowed Soloka to get into scoring position. Now the 2-2. Fastball outside at 82 on the radar gun. It's 3-2. So Jackson has gone from 0-2 down to a 3-2 count.
You're going to get some pro guys. There's a 0.70.
And now the payoff pitch from Swanson on the way to Jackson. Swing and a miss. Got him with the fastball running off the plate outside. And that's a big strikeout for out number two. So after a lengthy at bat, Jackson goes down swinging. And Gavin Rourke, the top of the lefties order, back up to the plate. Rourke also struck out his first time up. This time, though, he's trying to come up with a two-out base hit, find some outfield grass to give Soloka a chance to score from second. Ground ball to first, scooped up by Paxton, and that's going to be the inning. Nicely done by Swanson to work out of trouble. He keeps the HarbourCats ahead 1-0 as we go to the bottom of the third.
I'm in seven. I've got Tim here. We're going to play the waiting game, Tim. So I'm going to give you a prize right now, and you can take it, and that's it. Or we can wait till the seventh inning. If the HarbourCats are winning, you get a bigger...
We were getting married in the most beautiful rural setting. My mom got sick and couldn't be with us for our big day. I was heartbroken. Thankfully, we discovered ExploreNet. They responded right away and connected us to high-speed internet. Our big day was incredible because it felt like Mom was there.
ExploreNet. Connect to what matters.
Mmm, this is so good.
Let me show you why. Our growers, they select the beans. Not as easy as it seems. This one's perfect, that one too. So many great beans to brew.
Premium Arabica.
Ship them off to Canada.
Arrive at our roastery. Sorting, roasting every bean.
Taste test each cup.
Coffee masters give thumbs up.
Handcraft fresh brew.
Spreading joy is what we do.
From bean to cup, that is how we brew it up.
Cool. How are you making donuts?
On we go to inning number three in the bottom of the third inning. McGregor Sharp will begin this HarbourCats half of the third. He faces Joe Kinski, who has done a nice job so far on the hill for Port Angeles. Both pitchers have pitched well through the first couple frames. McGregor Sharp took a strike, nothing in one. First at bat here for Sharp, the number nine hitter today for the HarbourCats, before we go back to the top of the Victoria order. One ball and one strike now on Sharp. Victoria run. Came on a Harrison Spahn fielder's choice that scored a run with the bases loaded. 1-1 pitch. Good fastball at 85 in there for strike two. So Sharp, then back to the top for Playa, and then Nick Adams will hit next. It'll be his first at bat after Gus Wilson started the game, but Adams replaced him after the first inning. Breaking ball at 73 from Kinski, misses in the dirt. It's now 2-2.
Third inning's been great pace.
It's the best.
Liner into left field. That'll get through for a base hit. And McGregor Sharp is one for one. That is his first hit as a HarbourCat.
Hey, you want to walk?
Well, a chance here for us to remind you that Craft Services for Go Live Broadcast, brought to you by Molly's Fish and Chips here in Victoria, BC, one of the great food trucks at the park. And we thank Molly's, of course, for what they do for us all year long. Looking forward as well to the playoffs coming up. We expect that they will most likely be here along with the other food trucks for what we hope is a big crowd on Wednesday for the HarbourCats home playoff game, and maybe Thursday if necessary as well. Nick Playa back to the plate. He is one for one, came in to score the HarbourCats first run of the game on the Spahn fielder's choice. It was actually an infield hit that he reached on in the first inning. Wave and a miss by Playa. Good breaking ball there from Kinski. Got it by him. Nothing in two. Sharp at first. Nobody out. Bottom of the third inning. HarbourCats out hitting the lefties 3-0 here in the early frames. 0-2 to Playa. Breaks down and away and misses for 1-2. One ball, two strikes. Playa with a swing and a foul down the right side. It remains 1-2. Well, officially, the HarbourCats have won the division again in the second half. So they go into the playoffs as both the first and second half division winners in the North Division, and they're going to face the Wenatchee Apple Sox, who had the second best overall record across the whole season in the North Division. Playa takes one downstairs. 2-2 count here with nobody out. McGregor Sharp at first. HarbourCats lead 1-0, trying to add to it. Kinski sets at the letters, takes a peek over his shoulder. Playa grounds it foul, remains 2-2. So the Apple Sox were 29-23, and they were quite comfortably ahead in that department, the season-long record, because every other team in the North Division finished below 500 on the season. So you would say that the HarbourCats would go into that series as a slight favorite due to the home field advantage, but it really is a difficult matchup to predict. Playa grounds one to second. There's one on to first. There's two. Double play, and there's two down. Rosenberg to Altamirano to Soloka. Nicely turned by the lefties, and there's now two outs. Just back to the playoff matchup, and we'll continue to touch on that as today's game goes along. But it is a difficult matchup to predict, in large part because both teams have changed so much in recent weeks. HarbourCats, of course, losing a number of their players on their roster and getting a bunch of replacement players in. Wenatchee has also had to deal with the same sort of thing. And even so, both the HarbourCats and Apple Sox have been red hot these last couple of weeks in the regular season, despite the fact that they both lost players. So they should, both teams, be going into the playoffs feeling pretty good. Ball and a strike here on Nick Adams. Adams with a high towering fly ball down the left field line over towards foul ground, and it'll get back out of play. So it's now 1-2. Now the HarbourCats and Apple Sox, of course, played six games against each other as division opponents this season. But what makes it also difficult in terms of the matchup, what makes it difficult to read is that all six of those games were early in the season, in the first half in June. Now the 1-2 to Adams is downstairs and also out wide. It's 2-2. HarbourCats took 2 of 3 in Wenatchee in the opening series of the season back at the very start of June before sweeping the Apple Sox later in the month of June at Wilson's Group Stadium. So in total, Victoria took 5 of 6. But again, that was a while ago. This is a rocket deep left field. It's off the wall. Adams cruising into second, standing up with a two-out double. And he hit that ball right on the screws to the gap in left center, about halfway up the wall. Just missing his 8th home run of the summer by a handful of feet. Now just back to the Apple Sox as Griffin Paxton steps in, looking to knock in Nick Adams here with a 2-out base hit. But what makes it difficult is that those games when the HarbourCats won 5 of 6 from Wenatchee, the Apple Sox have almost seemed like an entirely different team here in the second half, both in terms of the rosters, but also Wenatchee has really flipped a switch. They've looked like a different team from the midway point of the season when the records reset. So it will be a very interesting season. They were 12-15 in the first half, but they're well above 500 in the second half. They really actually pushed the HarbourCats for the second half division crown all the way to the end. HarbourCats, though, did beat them out, so it's nothing more, though, than bragging rights for Victoria that they won the division in both halves, because Wenatchee was going to be their opponent in the first round either way. Paxton with a check swing, and it's taken downstairs, 2 balls and a strike. Paxton drew a walk in his first plate appearance. Nick Adams at second with a decent lead. The 2-1 pitch. Swinging a pop-up into foul ground. This will get back out of play. Now a 2-2 count on Griffin Paxton. Tyson Hayes would be next if Paxton can reach base to keep the inning going for the HarbourCats. Kinski looking for one more good pitch. He's just up over 50 now on the pitch count. He's at 53. And here comes the 2-2. Just a little foul tip by Paxton to stay alive. Didn't get much, but got a piece. One nothing, HarbourCats in front here in the bottom of the third inning. Run came back in the first, and that's all the offense we've had so far. Here's the 2-2. That one will miss. Full count, now 3-2. A So base is open at first, so Kinski does not necessarily have to throw a strike here to Paxton. The 3-2. That is strike three called on the outside corner. Kinski got him looking to end the inning, and it keeps it at 1-0 HarbourCats as we go to inning number four.
Fans, we're going down the third baseline for our team. That's a pedestrian who's trying to win Mexican dinner number 10. They're throwing the ball through the hole and not for team Mexican design. That is close. That is Brian down there throwing it, eh? We got Brian. So close. Restaurant, the last tortilla Mexicana on the authentic recipe is located just walking down the road at the HarbourCats and Go Live Broadcast came down to provide live broadcasts of the real games that are going to action. Here, make it a part of our team website and access to Go Live Broadcast. Tune in to select games on Shaw TV. Keep up with the action.
We go to inning number five here at Wilson's Group Stadium. Still a 1-0 HarbourCats lead in the season finale for both these two teams. HarbourCats, though, have the playoffs coming up. The Lefties heading home. And just the one more game for them here today before they all go back to their respective colleges for the fall. Nothing in one to Trevor Rosenberg leading off the inning for Port Angeles. 2-3-4 in their order. Rosenberg is swinging a foul down the right side. Nothing in two. So it'll be for the Lefties Rosenberg, DeHeiden, and Altamari to hit. Swanson still yet to allow a base hit in the game. He's through three innings, just one walk, and has struck out four. 0-2 up high. It's now 1-2. Swanson was able to work his way out of a little bit of a jam. Wouldn't call it a jam, more so just the first time he'd been in any sort of trouble in the ball game. Grounder foul. 1-2 still on Rosenberg. Swanson allowed a walk, and then he had a balk that allowed the runner to go to second with one out, but he got the next two guys. That one was close, but it just missed down and away. It's 2-2. Even count now on Trevor Rosenberg leading off the fourth inning for the Lefties. 2-2 pitch is a swing and a miss. Strikeout number five for Swanson. And there's one away. Well, just back to the playoffs and the discussion from the last inning. HarbourCats and the Apple Sox playing game one on Tuesday. Three-game division series before the three-game West Coast League Championship Series. Winner of the HarbourCats and Apple Sox will play against the winner of the Corvallis Knights and Walla Walla Suites, whoever wins the South Division Series. Now, if it's Corvallis, they would be going to their to try to win their fourth West Coast League title in a row if it is them that wins their first-round series. So the Knights trying to cement their dynasty. They've won the last three West Coast League championships. And, of course, on the other side, the other three teams in the playoffs trying to end that dynasty and make some history of their own. There's a hard liner to center, but it hangs up nicely for Playa off the bat of Reese DeHeiden, and there's two away.
It's the last, Zach.
So, again, it all starts Tuesday night in Wenatchee. Then it'll shift back to Victoria for game two on Wednesday and then game three if necessary on Thursday. I mentioned it earlier, but worth repeating, I'll be there in Wenatchee for game one, and we'll be broadcasting the game on Facebook Live on the HarbourCats Facebook page. But we are looking forward, though, to getting back home on Wednesday and being able to bring you our great broadcast on Go Live broadcast for the second game of the series and the third game on Thursday if it is needed. But first, HarbourCats will play the first game on the road, and they'll hope to bring a 1-0 series lead back to Victoria. One ball and no strikes here on Brad Altamari. The second baseman takes outside for 2-0. Bases are clear with two outs. Zach Swanson continues to work very quickly through this lefty's order. He's looked excellent on the hill. He's also managed to keep the pitch count very low. He's still yet to hit 50 pitches. That last one was number 48. 2-2 count now. Swanson looking for one more good pitch to get through four scoreless innings. And here comes the 2-2. There's a foul down the right side. Remains two balls and two strikes. That officially was pitch number 50. We'll see how much longer Swanson can go. Another 2-2 pitch from Swanson to Altamari coming up. And Swanson delivers. That one in the dirt. Good block by Sharp, although, of course, with no consequence. Nobody on base. It's now a full count, 3-2. Swanson trying to make it another 1-2-3 inning. Altamari awaits the pitch. Swanson looks in to Sharp for the signs and now comes home with the payoff delivery. Breaking ball misses in tight, so Swanson lost him for a 2-0 walk, and it will keep the inning alive for the lefties. Reese DeHeiden. Excuse me, it'll be Tommy Takayoshi, I should say, the catcher who will hit. DeHeiden, of course, has already made an out in this inning. First pitch to Takayoshi is a swing and a foul back, and it's nothing in one. Well, it's a pleasant day to be out at the yard. Not an overly sunny day, but not a bad temperature by any means. One more low-pressure regular season game left for the HarbourCats here before the games, and the pressure will certainly ramp up in the playoffs. Schindel's not going to get to that one. It's on the other side of the railing down in left field. No balls, two strikes here on Takayoshi. Swanson in command of this at bat. He's been throwing a lot of strikes. 32 strikes so far of his 54 pitches. And the 0-2. Hit out into center field. Playa coming on, not going to get there as it falls in front of him for a base hit. And with that, the no-hit bid for Zach Swanson goes by the wayside, but he still has been very good on the mound, and he's still looking to keep going strong through this fourth inning. Needs one more inning after this one to qualify himself for the win, but he needs to keep the lefties off the board to do that because the HarbourCats just have a narrow 1-0 lead. Both bullpens are quiet. We know all about, I've said it, the limited pitching options for Port Angeles here today. So Joe Kinski is going to be forced to go fairly deep into this game, really empty the tank. Swanson, we'll see again how long he goes, but the HarbourCats do have a bit more pitching depth to turn to later in the game out of the bullpen. It's Brad Altamari at second and Tommy Takayoshi with the first hit in the game. For Port Angeles, he's at first. On an 0 pitch up high, two balls, no strikes. Check that, it's a 1-1 count. The first pitch was a foul ball, so it's 1-1. This is Riley Quinton, 0-1 so far. Quinton struck out in his first at bat facing Swanson. That one well high, it's now 3-0. So Swanson just has lost the command a little bit to start this at bat. So he tries to get it back and put an end to this little mini two-out rally for the lefties. 2-1. Out in the left field, this is going to get down for a base hit. Getting the stop sign at third is Altamari. Bases are loaded with two away. Second hit in the inning for Port Angeles. And Swanson still, though, with a chance. He can get any out anywhere to get out of this inning without any damage. But this is really the first sign of trouble for him. So the hitter's going to be the right fielder, Dylan Sear. Sear 0 for 1, struck out in his first at bat. He has Quinton at first, Takeyoshi at second, Altamari at first, and there is a foul back. Nothing in one. Better way to start this at bat here for Zach Swanson after the falling behind and then allowing a base hit. Swanson looks in for the signs from McGregor Sharp. Now he's going to step off and reset himself before they go through the signs once again. Nothing in one. Downstairs, it's ball and a strike. Good block there by McGregor Sharp. Of course, important for him to block that with the tying run 90 feet away. HarbourCats do have a big gap up the middle. Tanner Haney is playing about halfway between first and second, so there is a lot of room if Sear can square one up. Out into left field, over to it to make the catch, Ty Schindel. And that gets Zach Swanson out of the inning unscathed. He is through four scoreless for the HarbourCats, and they have a 1-0 lead.
And we're heading back down the third baseline. Today we have Mason and Gavin. They're going to do the entire race. They're going to go from third base out around Harvey and back. On your marks, get set, go. The entire race brought to you by Fast Time Grand Prix, go-kart and archery tag located in Martinsville.
Tyson Hayes at the plate to begin the bottom of inning number four for the HarbourCats. 1-0 they lead. Zach Swanson was able to escape a bases loaded jam in the top of the inning. Got a line out to left field. Just hung up there in left for Ty Schindel to put it away and get Swanson out of the inning. One ball, no strikes here on Tyson Hayes. Well, the HarbourCats gave out their season-end awards before today's game. We caught a little bit of it after we welcomed you into the broadcast. with Griffin Paxton being named the Player of the Year. A couple of pitchers, Luca Green and Dakota Hawkins, the co-pitchers of the year. Harrison Spahn was the Community Player of the Year. And also Nick Playa was inducted into the HarbourCats Ring of Honor. So four certainly very well-deserved accolades for those four HarbourCats. 1-2 now to Tyson Hayes. And the pitch from Kinski is rolled on the ground to third. There for it is Quinton, the throw across the diamond in time to get Hayes, and there's one out. Now, aside from the awards, worth looking back at the 2019 season from a statistical standpoint and looking at the standout HarbourCats, Griffin Paxton leading the team with 30 runs driven in. Chase Mydroth officially was the batting average leader at .424, although he did not qualify on the West Coast League wide leaderboard because he did not have enough at-bats. Nick Adams, home run leader with 7 long balls this summer, and Parker Bramlett led the team with 33 stolen bases. Check that, 23 stolen bases. There was a hard foul by Harrison Spahn, no balls and a strike. Bases empty, one away, sun just peeking out as well here in this bottom of the fourth inning. HarbourCats out hitting the lefties 4-2, and they lead 1-0 in the run column. So again, Bramlett with 23 stolen bases, leading the HarbourCats. And then on the pitching side, as Spahn fouls it back to the screen, nothing at 2. Three HarbourCats pitchers had 4 wins. They were Ryan Watson, Calvin Turchin, and Aaron Celestino. Turchin led the team with 40 strikeouts as well. And inning pitched, he was also the leader with 40 1/3. Turchin started the year in the pen, then moved to the rotation and was excellent in both departments. He is a player that's going to be headed back to the University of Hawaii this season, and he's expected to be a big part of that Hawaii Rainbow Warriors baseball program. So hopefully for Turchin, he can keep that momentum going that he's gained this summer here with the HarbourCats. Now, as a team, the HarbourCats had a great year offensively. We know all about that. 0-2 to Spahn is downstairs, and it's 1-2. So the HarbourCats set West Coast League single season team batting records in runs and home runs. They are the first team ever to surpass the 400 run mark in a season. And coming into today, the HarbourCats are sitting at 409 runs, so make it 410 with the one they have on the board this afternoon. Spahn started his swing but held up. It's 1-2. Check that, it's 2-2. And now you look at the home run tally. HarbourCats hit 6 yesterday to bring their total to 53 homers for the season, which is also a new West Coast League record. 2-2 to Spahn. Downstairs, good take by Spahn, 3-2.
Good job, Aiden.
Now, with all of that said, the individual accolades and the stats that I just mentioned, of course, the main goal for the HarbourCats remains to bring home that elusive first West Coast League championship, and that's the task that they will try to accomplish over the next 2 weeks. Spahn with a fly ball out to left field, medium deep left, and it's caught by DeHeiden for out number 2.
Now batting the right fielder from Seattle University.
But just again to wrap up that point on the HarbourCats season, of course, they do want to get it done in the playoffs this year. That's the main goal. But regardless, no matter what happens in the playoffs, it has been just a fantastic season of HarbourCats baseball here in Victoria. They're 7th in the West Coast League. Fans here are great, and they've been treated to an excellent team on the diamond to be able to watch here in the summer of 2019. HarbourCats have had a lot of good players, and it's always hard to predict. You never know in baseball, but I think you'd be wise, if you've tracked this team throughout this summer, you'd be wise to keep an eye on a lot of the names on this roster in the next 4, 5, 6 years. You might well see a few of them in the big leagues, because this is a talented team that the HarbourCats put together. They showed it all summer. They have certainly some exciting prospects coming into the college baseball and then eventually the pro baseball world, but probably a couple years away still from some of those guys getting some more national attention. There is a strike to Kyle Sherrick on the outside corner. 3-1 with 2 outs, bases clear. Good hitters count for Sherrick. The 3-1 pitch from Kinski is a swing and a miss. It's 3-2. Got him to chase down low below the knees. Well, Kinski's been excellent so far for Port Angeles. Just the one run allowed. He has really been going toe-to-toe with Zach Swanson on the HarbourCats side. And the 3-2 pitch. Wave and a miss. No, it's a foul. And I think that caught Takeyoshi in the wrong spot. He's going to try to walk that off. Looked at first like Sherrick swung and missed at that pitch, but no, he did get a little piece of it. Looks like Takeyoshi's going to be okay. A smile on his face, that's a good sign. Three balls, two strikes, two out to Kyle Sherrick. And the pitch from Kinski. Up high, ball four. So it misses. Sherrick takes his walk. And he will trot down to first. It'll not be a 1-2-3 inning for Joe Kinski. As the HarbourCats keep it alive.
Your cool summer shirt batter from Texas. Number two, Tanner
Okay. There goes Sherrick on the first pitch. The throw from Takeyoshi is wide of the bag at second. Sherrick has another stolen base. That's something that can be a real weapon for the HarbourCats in the postseason. Because what we've seen from Sherrick is that he can really steal a base effortlessly for the HarbourCats. He's been very good in that department. HarbourCats are a team that like to run a lot. Todd Haney emphasizes that to his speedy guys. When you get on, look for chances to run. Haney takes strike one, ball and a strike now on him. But Sherrick is someone who is not just running to hope to steal a bag, he expects to steal a bag, and he gets great jumps. And by the time he gets up to top speed, very hard to throw out. In the dirt, good block by Takeyoshi. That one bounced out in front of home plate. Two balls and a strike on Tanner Haney, who is one for one so far. Haney had a little bloop that fell in for a base hit in his first at bat. With that hit, he's seen his average rise up to 276. Another returning player, Haney was here last year, did not play a ton as an incoming freshman at the University of Texas, but after his redshirt season at Texas, he has been a regular in the HarbourCats lineup. Good defender at second, and he's also enjoyed some more success with the bat at the plate. Three balls, one strike now on Haney. Trying to knock in Kyle Sherrick from second with a two-out base hit to extend the HarbourCats lead. That misses to Haney downstairs below the knees. So it's a walk with two away, and there's two on and two out. Ty Schindel will get another chance to hit. Schindel 0 for 1. It has, though, been a great series for Schindel. 2 for 4 yesterday and 4 for 5 in game 1. Native of Victoria, BC. He's certainly been a beneficiary, Schindel, of the fact that there have been a lot of departures recently for the HarbourCats, because he has stepped in and he's done an excellent job filling in. This one gets underneath Altamari around third. Sherrick coming home. He will score. And the HarbourCats double their lead to 2-0. That was a rocket to second, just snuck under the glove of Brad Altamari. They're going to call it an error. But regardless, HarbourCats do score a run. Their first run since the first inning. And it's a 2-0 game. Just to finish the point on Schindel, fact is that he didn't see the field a lot, didn't get many at-bats throughout most of the middle portion of the season, but he did at the start of the year and now again at the end of the year, and he's really making the most of it. Perhaps showing the HarbourCats that, hey, maybe he could have played a little more during the season. That will miss up high to McGregor Sharp. One ball, no strikes. The fact is, though, that the HarbourCats had a lot of depth all over the field, and the outfield was no different. There were some excellent, excellent players in Victoria this summer. Likes of Jason Willow, who made center field his home, and he did a great job out there in the two spot in the HarbourCats lineup. Nick Playa, of course. Schindel takes his lead off of first. He's not being held on with Haney at second. One ball, one strike count on McGregor Sharp. 2-0 now, the lead for the HarbourCats. And here comes the 1-1 pitch from Kinski. Wave and a miss by Sharp. It's 1-2. Sharp singled in his first at bat, a solid line drive base hit into left field. So he's 1-for-1. Another one of those here would give Haney a good chance to score from second. One ball, two strikes. That one misses off the plate outside for 2-2.
Next booger.
That one down low. 3-2 now to McGregor Sharp. That, by the way, was pitch 85 for Joe Kinski. So he's starting to near the century mark on the mound. Probably has, maybe if he can get out of this here, one more inning at most left. The 3-2. That's strike three called on the outside corner. And McGregor Sharp down looking to end the inning. Kinski gets out of it with just the one run allowed. And the HarbourCats take a 2-0 lead to the fifth here on Go Live Broadcast in Shaw Spotlight.
And Gallagher Benefits, this year they donate $50 for Yellow Flame Returns and help to fill a dream foundation. But Ted, you know what? This is all about getting something for you. We're going to do the Tim Hortons Coffee Cup Shuffle, buddy.
How's sales going?
Sales have been good. No, we're having a really good night. It's nice to finally have some warm weather. Team's playing really well, so it's nice to see everyone coming out to the ballpark and enjoying the atmosphere, and the merchandise this year seems to be quite popular with everyone. So really, it's win-win for everyone here.
Gotta love it. Another day at the park.
Another day at the ballpark. The more HarbourCat gear we see in the stands, the better. We get a lot of compliments from people. We get a lot of people that are coming to the store asking where such and such item is because they see someone wearing it. I love seeing it in the community. I'm starting to see it around more and more, and people are starting to share it on social media. We've got a new sale on right now that's been quite popular. Any items that are purchased $60 or more, we're offering a complimentary general admission ticket to a future game. That does include our fireworks games as well. We also just got in our team game hats. These are the two hats that the team is wearing on the field this year. Our website, www.harbourcats.com. You can click on the link for the cat shop. Any of the merchandise that we have at the ballpark is now on the store website as well. And we do have a U.S. link as well. We don't have as many items for sale with the U.S. link, but there are customers or fans from south of the border, any parents, if they're looking to pick up some HarbourCats merchandise and can't make it up to Victoria, they can definitely purchase through that avenue as well.
We go to inning number 5 here on a cloudy Sunday afternoon, Wilson's Group Stadium in Victoria. Thanks for tuning in on Go Live Broadcast in Shaw Spotlight. There's a breaking ball from Zach Swanson over to Brandon Soloka for a strike. Another breaking ball popped up. Tanner Haney behind second base will make the catch just out onto the edge of the outfield grass, and there's one out. Well, Swanson's been very good so far tonight, and on he goes, and now into the fifth. He needs two more outs to qualify himself for the win. He's managed to be very economical also with his pitch count. 64 pitches so far, so the next one here, the nothing and nothing pitch to Carson Jackson will be pitch number 65, and it was waved on and missed for nothing and one. Jackson put up a good battle in his first at bat facing Swanson, but then ultimately struck out on a 3-2 pitch. There's a breaking ball in behind him. Swanson, I think, just lost the grip on it. One ball, one strike. HarbourCats, or the Lefties, I should say, will go back to the top of their order after this at bat, and that one came inside and hit Carson Jackson. So Swanson with a hit by pitch there of Carson Jackson, and that'll be one on and one out now for Port Angeles here in the top of the fifth inning. We'll take this time now to welcome in HarbourCats managing partner and GM, Jim Swanson, to the broadcast here for the fifth inning. Jim, thanks for taking the time to join us.
Thank you very much, Mike. Looking forward to spending some time with you on the road in the coming days here.
Yeah, well, looking forward to getting out on the road to Wenatchee. I'm going to ask you about that lots. Don't worry. But we got to start with the man on the mound for the HarbourCats today, because it's your son, Zach, and he's been great, hasn't he?
You know what? He's up there. He's a gutsy kid, and he's battling. I love it.
Runner goes. McGregor Sharp's throw down to second is not going to be in time. So, Saloka, or I should say Jackson, with a stolen base. And he's now in scoring position with one out. This is Gavin Rourke at the plate in a 1-1 count.
We're proud of him. As a family, we're proud of him. He's put in a lot of work to be in this spot. It's a hard spotlight for him to be in, maybe, as the owner's kid, to be on the mound and to be pitching for the team. But I think he's earned every bit of it. And it's all on him. And that's a lot of fun for us to watch this happen.
Slow grounder towards first goes foul. It's now 1-2. Well, he was able to strand the bases loaded in the last inning. Got maybe just a little lucky, but got the line out to left field, the Ty Schindel, and he's allowed just two hits in the game. Now, he pitched at San Diego Christian this past year, and he's hoping to go back there and be an even bigger part of their pitching staff. So what are the positives that you've seen from just a scouting perspective, even though I know he's your son, but from watching him this summer, how do you think he has developed?
It's fun to watch him learning from the guys around him, because we have such quality guys that he's been able to learn from, and that's been the fun too. And he's been juggling a pretty tough schedule. He's had to work all summer long as well. He hasn't been able to travel with the team. He's been able to compete in our non-league games mostly, which is why it might look like he hasn't pitched very much for us this summer, but he's pitched a little bit more than I think the basic stats show, because he's not part of a lot of the stats when it comes to the West Coast League stats. But you know what? He's a kid who loves the game. He works very hard. He's working very hard at getting bigger and thicker and the workout plan, and trying to get some food to stick to his ribs like his dad doesn't seem to have trouble with.
Yes, no, Swanson did, as you mentioned, he pitched in Nanaimo earlier this year. He pitched against Seattle City here in Victoria. He started that game, I believe, against Seattle City, a non-league game. So you're right, he has thrown more than the West Coast League stats would lead you to believe. But this is his first West Coast League start. Certainly he has been up to the challenge. It's a full count, 3-2. Gavin Rourke at the plate. Lefties. Yeah,
it's his second outing of the week against the lefties and in West Coast League play, and had a decent outing earlier in the week. Struck out some guys, I think 4 and 2 innings, and gave up 2 hits. But yeah, I mean, I think he's a kid who's earned the respect of his teammates and the coaches, and that's why they gave him the ball here today and trying to finish out the season strong. And, you know, the innings that he's eating up right now, too, are helping us to set up for the playoffs, which I think is a real positive. And, you know, sometimes that's a guy's role, is to eat up some innings and help the team get into that position.
3-2 pitch, just missing up high to Rourke, so it's a one-out walk, first and second here with one away in the inning. Well, certainly Swanson has been good so far. He's still trying to get through a scoreless top of the fifth to qualify him for the win here this afternoon. He's also leading the West Coast League, I might add, in ERA with a 0.00 ERA on the season.
You know what, he's for whatever reason, he's always been somewhat discounted. He's a smaller guy coming through, but always, think through hopefully some good coaching he had from a number of people, myself maybe included on that, the mechanics were always pretty solid, and he's got some things.
This could be two. There's one at third. Adams throws it to first. That's a double play. Tag applied by Paxton, and that's the inning. It's a 5-3 double play to end the inning. Swanson threw 5 scoreless. He's in line for the win. And we are going to keep it right here with Jim Swanson, the managing partner and GM for the HarbourCats in the inning break. How about that?
That's a lot of fun to watch that play happen, especially for a guy like Nick Adams, who plays more infield at college than outfield. He's been learning a new spot with outfield here, and obviously leading our team in home runs right now, and which is kind of fun to watch as well for a junior college guy in our league, and maybe a guy who had to battle to make the team a little bit here this year. Not necessarily make the team, but to get his time and his at-bats, and he's earned them, and been able to get there. But if I can, Mike, I just want to go sideways for a second here in a really good way. One of our great season ticket holders, Neil Beveridge, who sits down there on the left side with Grandma Dynamite and the crew there. Neil, we want to say hi to you. You're in hospital at Jubilee Hospital. For those who don't know, Neil is battling, and we believe he's going to win a battle with terminal cancer right now that's spread on him a little bit. And Neil, we miss you at the games, buddy. A lot of people are asking about you, where you are, and how you're doing. So it's something that our summer family here is behind you, and it's great that you have Chris and Mara there with you in the room. And but I know you're watching this game right now on Shaw in your room. And thanks to Shaw, and thanks to Chris Jaycox and Go Live, Mike, all you guys who are working on this right now on this broadcast, that you're able to bring this to a guy like Neil, who's been a real big part of our summer family, and he's done a lot of things on the side. Mike, I'm sorry I'm going on this a little bit, but he's donated camp registrations to kids who maybe can't afford to come to our summer camps and our skills camps. They don't even know about it. They'll never know that Neil did that. But many things that Neil has made donations to, Anawim House and different things that nobody ever knows about. And Neil, I know about it, and I'm glad to tell people that you've done so many great things for so many people. You're a wonderful man.
Well, that's awesome. Yeah, we'll hope Neil keeps on battling. I'm sure he'll have a smile on his face as he watches the baby shark step up at the plate to lead off this inning. Playa takes a breaking ball that was running inside. One ball, no strikes.
But for sure, thanks for bringing up about my son. It's been fun to watch him seeing his fastball get up to as high as 84 here today.
Playa strokes one out into right field. That'll be a base hit. So Playa is 2 for 3 now today. Well, now let's, if you don't mind, Jim, let's shift our focus to the playoffs, because, of course, it's the big thing coming up this week. HarbourCats going to Wenatchee on Tuesday. They played the Apple Sox all 6 games in the first half. So I think you kind of throw that out, the head-to-head
totally.
Season series, and you judge this series coming up just kind of on its own. But how are you feeling about the HarbourCats' chances going into Tuesday?
You know what? I like our chances, and the reason is because I love the work our coaches have done with our players all season long, and I really like our people that are in uniform out there battling between the lines. I think we have just great young men, and I can't speak highly enough of those who have battled here to the end. It's a long season for these college players, but all of them want to be pros, and if they want to be pros to that next level, they've got to be able to go day in, day out, and grind it out for as long as six and a half months if you're in the big leagues, and they all want to be there.
Nick Adams out into right field. This ball is going to be caught. Nice diving catch by Sear in right. Playa tags and advances up to third, but there is now one out. Great effort out there in right field by Dylan Sear.
And you know what? The other thing, it's, you know, you saw the presentations before the game. Community Player of the Year, Harrison Spahn, who's been a great player for us for 2 years, and he's even a better person. We've fallen in love with his, not just him, but his family, and the impact he's had on people here has been so important in helping to build the culture here that we've had a chance to change over the last couple of years, and really get into we want to win here, we want to win the right way. And Harrison Spahn's a big part of that. And as Nick Playa has lifted for a pinch runner to get him a chance to rest up a little bit more before Tuesday, as Finn Chester goes in to run for him at third base, you know what? It's one of those things where we're excited to see. We're excited to see how these men that we gave the awards to here today, we'll talk about more of that in a second, how they progress in their lives and their baseball lives as well.
Fly ball out into left center field. We'll see if this is deep enough to score Chester. It'll be caught in center by Rourke. His throw home is going to be late. So Chester tags and scores to make it 3-0. And Paxton picks up RBI number 31 on the season. So Paxton, the leading RBI man for the HarbourCats, he was awarded the Player of the Year before the game today. And you can just, Jim, continue on those awards before the game.
Yeah, so we did, Griffin Paxton's a guy who just missed their consistency and really a warrior. His teammates around him could not help but notice that he was ready to play and wanted to play every day. He just wouldn't give in on an at-bat. He wouldn't give in on a play. And he reminds me of Tucker Johnson, Alex DeGody, and some guys like that that have really done an amazing job for us over the years.
That's going to be an extra base hit for Tyson Hayes.
Birthday boy Tyson Hayes, I might add. It's his birthday today.
All right, happy birthday, Tyson, and he has a one-out double. HarbourCats keeping the offense coming here in the bottom of the fifth inning.
And then, of course, the pitchers of the year, we had a tough time narrowing it down. Of course, such a difference now between starters and relievers. You can't really compare the two. Luca Green has been a dependable guy for us all year. He's been here all season. He's kept to his word to stay here all season, which certainly helps out as well. But from Pomona Pitzer, he's been one of those guys that just, he wants to play baseball. And we love baseball players who want to play baseball. Guys who don't want to play baseball, they get weeded out at this level, and they find out that maybe baseball isn't for them and they should go on to their other careers. But Luke has been a really good guy for us in the bullpen.
Fly ball deep left field. It is gone. Home run number 7 for Harrison Spahn, a 2-run shot that scores Tyson Hayes. And it is 5-0, HarbourCats.
And that puts him in a tie for the team lead with Nick Adams for home runs on the season. That's a great thing for Coach Gary Adcock and the coaches back at CBU. Cal Baptist will be very happy to see what Harrison Spahn has done here this summer.
I'm sure they were happy with what he did last year. They sent him back this year, and he's been even better in 2019.
And then I think the other part of the Pitcher of the Year award was Dakota Hawkins, who's just been so reliable. And I believe he's going to be game one starter for us in Wenatchee on Tuesday.
Well, that'll bring Kyle Sherrick up to hit. Now, just with two outs here in the inning, Jim, I should let you know that at the end of this inning, we got to wrap it up quick because we got the Kiss Cam coming up, which our camera crew does for the fans at the park. So we'll wrap up the interview quick at the end of the inning. Not that we don't want you rambling because you provide great information for us, but as you would be the first to admit, we know that that is something you tend to do.
No, I tell you what, Mike, I'm going to run out of here quickly because Kiss Cam may make you want to try to kiss me. And my wife wouldn't like that very much, and I just don't want that to happen again, okay?
All right, you
like
know
last
what?
Time.
All right. Well, we appreciate you, as always, stopping by, Jim. It's been a blast for us on Go Live to work with you this summer again and get to you up on the broadcast every now and again. We'll hope maybe to get you up here on Wednesday during the playoff game.
Or during the playoff game when you're in Wenatchee. And
yeah.
Remember, you're the rookie on the bus.
That's yeah.
You get to carry my bags. Okay?
All right. Yeah, no, I will be going on the bus to Wenatchee. And we'll broadcast that on Facebook Live as well for Tuesday night. So you can follow along. It's a 2-2 count here to Kyle Sherrick with two away. Bases empty. HarbourCats exploding for 3 runs. The 2-run blast by Harrison Spahn a moment ago.
Thanks, Mike. I'm out of here, brother. I'm going to get out of here now.
All right. Thanks, Jim. There's a pitch missing down low. No, it's a strike to Harrison or to Kyle Sherrick. So that's all for the HarbourCats in the 5th inning. 5-0 they lead as we go to the 6th.
Our Canadian Tire game day crew is raking the field. I think it's time for a little Kiss Cam brought to you by Glow Restaurant. Pay attention to the screen. Apparently people, that's not what kissing is. Got anybody willing to kiss on the kiss? Is this thing on? Excitement is mounting. We're on a roll. Oh, wow. This is a family show. I think that'll be our winner. Whereabouts are they? Are they right there in the middle? All right, I gotta give it to the guys. Now pitching for your HarbourCats. From Dallas Baptist, number 47, Reagan McDonald. We're back here for inning number 6 at Wilson's Group Stadium. HarbourCats have extended the lead to 5-0.
And Regan McDonald is the new pitcher on for Victoria, standing at 6'9 from Dallas Baptist University. Tall left-hander. He's 1-1 with a 4.21 ERA in 6 appearances and 4 starts on the summer. McDonald will just probably get a couple of innings here. We'll see how long he goes, but we wouldn't expect him to go too long because the HarbourCats probably want to keep him fresh for the playoffs. He's been an important arm in the HarbourCats rotation in recent outings. 1-1 pitch to Reese DeHeiden bounces, and it's 2-1. Well, McDonald in his last start was very good earlier this week on August the 7th in Port Angeles. He went 5 innings, allowed 2 runs on 2 hits and 2 walks while striking out 11 in just those 5 innings. So he was very sharp on the mound on that day against the lefties. Good fastball. Catching the zone 2-2 now to DeHeiden. Even count now, the 2-2 pitch. High chopper towards short. Spawn fields it. His throw is in time at first. And that gets DeHeiden for the out. There is one away. We also have a handful of defensive changes here in this inning for the HarbourCats. So Andrew McQuaig has taken over in center for Nick Playa, who was pinch run for by Finn Chester. So McQuaig is into the game in center field. Liam Balance is into the game at first for Griffin Paxton. So both Playa and Paxton, of course, we know how important they are to the HarbourCats batting order. And they're getting a little extra rest before the series opener on Tuesday. Another chance for Spawn and another out. And so there is two away. Nice job by Regan McDonald so far. A couple of quick outs on just 5 pitches. And he has a chance for a very fast 1-2-3 inning here. This is the catcher, Tommy Takeyoshi. Wave and a miss by him. Nothing in one. Takeyoshi, 1-for-2 on the ball game. No balls, 1 strike. McGregor sharp, puts down the signs. McDonald delivers the pitch, and it's a strike. Good fastball at 86. Painting the inside corner, nothing in 2. No balls, 2 strikes. Bouncer right back to the mound. McDonald fields it, flips it underhand. That's the inning. 1-2-3 go the lefties on just 9 pitches. Here in the top of the 6th. HarbourCats in front, 5-0 as we head to the bottom half.
Take it away, Shane.
What'd you say?
All right, thank you, Dan. Turn the mic on, hello.
So, so your catcher yelled time.
You guys did a couple of cool here today with all you got. Yes,
able to purchase land to build a new public safety building using provincial gaming revenue from hosting Elements Casino Victoria. The new building has larger sleeping quarters, so volunteer firefighters can be on call, on site, and respond to emergencies even faster. The building isn't only home to the town's fire department, though. It also has space for public safety staff and a secondary emergency operations center, too. BCLC, we're community-minded, with your community in mind.
second baseman from the University of Texas, number 2, Tanner Katie.
5-0, the HarbourCats are on top of the Port Angeles Lefties, looking to finish off the sweep this weekend to close out the regular season. We thank you again for sending in your tweets, getting a chance to show some more of them. Remember, use the hashtag HarbourCats. Your tweet could be featured on the broadcast. First pitch to Tanner Haney is missing up and in. HarbourCats will send Haney, Schindel, and Sharp to the plate, bottom third of the order here in this sixth inning. They scored 3 in the last inning, including a 2-run home run by Harrison Spahn. That was his 7th of the summer to pull him into a tie with Nick Adams for the team lead in home runs. Adams and Spahn should get both one more at bat, perhaps to try to go yard and take the solo team lead for the regular season in the home run tally. 2-1. Haney down the left field line. That is a foul ball. Hit it hard, and it was certainly going to be an extra base hit had it stayed fair, but it just landed maybe 2 or 3 feet foul. For the HarbourCats, 5 runs on 7 hits. Lefties have no runs on 2 hits and 1 error. Zach Swanson is in line for the win, going 5 innings. He allowed just 2 hits, 3 walks, 5 strikeouts, and no runs. Regan McDonald with a very quick 1-2-3 inning in the 6th. HarbourCats did have a right-hander up in the bullpen a moment ago, but that right-hander has sat down now. Haney strikes out for the first out of the bottom of the 6th. So we are going to expect that, at least we think, Regan McDonald will be back out for the top of the 7th inning. This is Ty Schindel now for Victoria. Schindel today 0-2. Takes down low and off the plate outside. Ball and no strikes. Big looping breaking ball. Misses downstairs for 2 balls and no strikes on Schindel. McGregor Sharp will be next. HarbourCats again made a number of defensive changes, so we will see a handful of new names making their first at bat. Schindel down the left field line. Long run for DeHeiden into foul ground. He's not going to get there as it lands near the bullpen of the lefties. 2 balls, 1 strike. The 2-1 pitch. That'll miss downstairs, 3-1. So a good chance here for Schindel to pick something out and try to drive it with a 3-1 count. Pitch from Kinski. Missing ball 4. So Schindel takes a walk with 1 out. Kinski now is up over the 100 pitch mark. So he's starting to, we would expect at least, starting to run out of stamina. He's thrown now 108 pitches. We would expect this to be his last inning, and then the lefties will just kind of try to piece together a couple more frames. Out to right center field. This ball could fall in. Diving catch made by Gavin Rourke. He lost his hat and made the play. Took a single away from McGregor Sharp. What a play out there in right center. It was right into no man's land, and Rourke sped over there in a headlong dive, was able to make the play. So that'll bring in Andrew McQuaig for his first at bat. Schindel goes for second. The throw down, not in time. Schindel stole second base. Now, Altamari is arguing that Schindel may have got his hand in first, but his hand lost contact with the bag when the tag was applied, but Altamari is not going to win that appeal. So Schindel is ruled safe at second. Certainly got the hand in first. The only question is whether the hand came off. But Schindel is up there safely at second. He's running again for third, and there's no throw. Back-to-back stolen bases for Ty Schindel. He's now at third with two away. McQuaig at the plate. And one ball, one strike. Nick Adams will be next if the inning gets to him. The 0-2. Swinging a pop-up down the right field line. No one's going to get there for Port Angeles.
No. Border issue.
No balls, two strikes, two out. Runner at third for the HarbourCats, trying to add to their 5-0 lead. The pitch to McQuaig. Held up, and it gets away. Schindel's going to come in to score. And how about that? Those two stolen bases by Ty Schindel pay off because he comes in to score on a wild pitch. It is now 1-2. And Schindel made that happen with the 2-0 walk and then stole second, then stole third, and scored on the wild pitch. 1-2. That's going to be in there for strike three called to Andrew McQuaig, and that will end the inning. HarbourCats add another run on the wild pitch. It's 6-0 as we head to the seventh.
Time for the Good Life Fitness Bumble Ball Contest. Today we have David and Lizzie.
Thank you.
The object, knock over the other one's pillar before yours is knocked over. On your marks, get set, go! I think Harvey wins today. Now pitching for your HarbourCats, number 36, Tim Pollock.
We're back here for the late innings on Shaw Spotlight and Go Live Broadcast. 6-0, HarbourCats in front. First pitch is flown out to center field. Andrew McQuaig gets over to it to retire Riley Quinton. That's out number one on one pitch for the new right-hander into the game for Victoria. That is Tim Hollick, native of Nanaimo, BC. So Hollick, I do not believe, will be eligible for the postseason because this is his first appearance for Victoria, but still getting a good chance for him to get into a game, get some West Coast League experience under his belt. Fastball at 83 off the plate for one ball and no strikes. This is Dylan Sear at the dish. He's 0 for 2 today. Big swing and a miss, and it's 1-1 to Dylan Sear. Bases clear, one out, tops of the seventh inning. Lefties trying to get something on the board here in the late innings. Would hate to go home empty-handed without a run in their final game of the year, so they are doing their best to try to push a run across. It's now 1-2. Hollick looks in, and he's now set. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Started to go. He went around. That's a strikeout for Hollick as Sear could not hold up on the swing. There's two down. Well, the HarbourCats just falling short of setting a new West Coast League attendance record for the season. This afternoon's attendance, 2,258. There was greater than 4,000 yesterday, and also over 2,500 the day before. But they're just falling a tiny bit short by about 200 fans of setting a new season-long record. Still, though, was a good attendance year for the HarbourCats. Harrison Spahn puts that away. It's a very quick 1-2-3 inning for Tim Hollick. And we go to the stretch at Wilson's Group Stadium, still 6-0 HarbourCats.
Only takes one, eh?
Yeah.
You want to split it? Oh, you got more.
Take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the
to the bottom of inning number 7, and a new pitcher on for Port Angeles. It is Riley Quinton taking over on the hill. So Quinton getting the start at third base, and now he'll take over on the mound for the lefties. They did get 6 good innings from Joe Kinski. He did allow the 6 runs, but he pitched better than that. There's a pop-up by Adams that's caught at second by Altamari for the out, and there's one down. So Kinski goes 6 innings. He allowed Six runs on seven hits and five walks with five strikeouts. And again, the numbers for him were not the greatest, but most of the damage came towards the end of that start when the pitch count was really elevated for him. And just with the lack of options in the bullpen available to the lefties, he kind of had to stay in longer than I'm sure the lefties would have liked. So Kinski did start out very well. He allowed just one earned run through the first three innings of the game and two earned runs through the first four innings. HarbourCats have six runs on seven hits now. Balance pops one up. He hit a home run yesterday. This one over towards the dugout, and it's going to drop in.
Nice drive.
Also replacing Riley Quinton at third is Bo Blowers. He's into the game at third base. That was probably a ball that Blowers would have taken charge of, but Quinton, being a natural infielder, starting the game as the third baseman, I think he was still in fielding mode, trying to go after that one himself. Now the 1-1 pitch to Balance. He gets a second life at the plate. Takes it down low for 2-1. I mentioned Balance hit a home run yesterday for his first long ball of the season with the HarbourCats.
Doesn't even need to spin.
Hey, Pat would love to see that one. We'll get video.
Swinging a foul away there by Balance. 2-2. Bases clear, one out, bottom of the seventh inning. HarbourCats trying to keep on adding to this 6-0 lead here on the final day of the West Coast League regular season. Balance will take down low. It's 3-2. Tyson Hayes will be next. Three, two. Rocket down the left field line, but it's foul. So Balance hit a pop-up that probably should have been caught in foul ground, and then he hit a rocket that would have been an extra base hit for sure, and he kept it fair, but also went into foul ground. It's been an eventful at bat for him, but he's going to pick up a bat again and step into the left-handed or the right-handed hitting batter's box. Full count, 3-2. Now a pop-up in fair territory at third base. It's going to be Blowers, and he lets it fall in. So after all that, Balance is going to be at first, and we'll see if that's a hit or an error. Only a question of whether Blowers touched that ball, and they say he did not. So no decision for the official score. It is a base hit.
That's hilarious.
So here now Tyson Hayes. Doubled hard to the wall and earlier in the game, and he rips one into left field for a base hit here. Stopping at second, Balance. Hayes has another hit. He is now 2-for-3. Harrison Spahn will be next. He hit a two-run home run in his last at bat. I mentioned Riley Quinton on the mound. We did see him on the mound earlier in this series with the lefties needing pretty much anyone who can pitch to do so.
Come on, Hayden.
Balance now at second, Hayes at first, Spahn at the plate. If he gets another long ball here, would give him the solo lead on the season in the home run leaderboard for the HarbourCats with 8. Spahn has already driven in 3 today. 2-run homer, and also picked up an RBI on a fielder's choice. So overall now, up to 25 runs driven in on the campaign.
Hit it for the bottle rocket.
Just a little hand, like hammer and helper.
Nothing in one as Spahn fouled away the first pitch by Quinton. Another one fouled away. Quickly, nothing in two.
Mm-hmm.
First and second, one out, the 1-2 to Spawn. That's a strike, and it's in there for strike three called. So Spawn strikes out this time. He's now 1-for-4 with that 2-run homer. Kyle Sherrick is going to get another chance to hit. He's 0-for-2, but he has walked and scored a run. First pitch to Sherrick, swung on and missed. No balls, one strike.
Number 54, Kyle Sherrick.
Well, if the HarbourCats can keep this lead, that means the lefties only need to get 4 more outs on the pitching side. Sherrick flies one in the air, deep right field. Back on its sear towards the wall. It is going to be caught on the warning track, actually, by Rourke in right center. The center fielder got over to it, and Rourke made the play deep on the warning track to make that catch and end the inning. HarbourCats held off the board in the seventh. On we go to the eighth, still 6-0.
Where's Waldo?
9, 10, go!
There you go.
See, Scott, they needed you.
All right, I'm here playing the waiting game with Tim. The deal was the HarbourCats are winning after 7
to the price, and we love the
game. They sure are. Tim, I got some announcements for you.
That fucking hurt.
Which I can't say fast. Congratulations, and thanks for supporting the HarbourCats.
Oh, man. It's really, really hard note today, eh?
Leading off for the lefties, number 29, Bo Flowers.
On we go to inning number 8 here at Wilson's Group Stadium, still 6-0. The HarbourCats have the lead. This is Bo Blowers at the plate. The lefties have forfeited the DH spot. They have moved Blowers in at third base to take over for Riley Quinton. So the starting DH, Carson Jackson, is out of the game. So Blowers hitting for him. Down the left field line, this goes out of play, foul. Quickly, nothing in two. Tim Hollick got through a very quick 1-2-3 inning in the seventh. He needed just 7 pitches to do so. The 0-2. Softly hit into left. That'll get through for a base knock.
Scott, are you doing the dizzy bet?
Just over top of the HarbourCats infield. Flowers was able to just kind of muscle it over the head of Nick Adams and also Harrison Spawn at short. Well, we've talked a lot about the HarbourCats, and rightly so. They're headed for the playoffs. The lefties heading back to Port Angeles after this game to kind of just wrap up their season and then head to their colleges for the year. Nick Adams takes that one in off the bat of Rourke, and there's one out. But it is worth looking at the lefties as well. And as they close out their 2019 season here today, if you look at their season as a whole, say for the final week of the season here this week, which was not a good week for them, but if you look at their overall season as a whole, the lefties were quite competitive this year in the North Division. And in particular in the second half, they were in the hunt for a playoff spot right up until the final week. And they also had some very good players play for them this summer. None better than Matt Christian, the West Coast League Home Run Derby champion at the All-Star Game festivities. He also led the West Coast League in home runs this summer with 12. The next closest was Bellingham's Troy Viola with 8. So Christian was an exciting bat for the fans in Port Angeles to watch this summer. Certainly one to keep an eye on. This one will sneak through in for a base hit to left field. So first and second, one out now in the top of the eighth inning. But you look at the lefties, and it was another year, their third in the West Coast League since they joined in 2017, replacing the Kitsap Blue Jackets. It was another year where they did see some small improvement. In fact, the lefties have technically improved record-wise each year. They were 19-34 in their first season before 21-33 last year. Assuming they do not come back here to win this game, they will finish 22-32 here in 2019. But it is just kind of small little baby steps for them so far, their first 3 years of existence. So the challenge next year then for Port Angeles is to see if they can really improve by a bit and see if they can challenge for a playoff spot or maybe even get in the playoffs next year. First things first, try to get a little closer to the 500 mark. It does take, though, a handful of seasons to really get good college relationships for recruiting a high caliber of players to your summer collegiate program, so that the lefties have had 3 years now to kind of develop some of those relationships, and they're hopeful that next year they'll be able to get some good players back and then make a challenge, A, to get close to the 500 mark, maybe have a winning record, and maybe try to get in the playoffs for their first time in franchise history.
Swing and a miss
for the out. Both runners will move up on the wild pitch. That was Reese DeHeiden striking out. Rosenberg is at second base. Blauer is at third. And now Brad Altomare will try to knock in those two runs for the lefties here with a two-out base hit in the top of the eighth inning. Popped up. This should get Hulick out of it. He's going to give way to Liam Balance, who makes the catch. And that is the inning. So Tim Hulick strands runners at second and third. HarbourCats still lead 6-0 as we head to the bottom of the eighth.
We were getting married in the most beautiful rural setting. My mom got sick and couldn't be with us for our big day. I was heartbroken. Thankfully, we discovered ExploreNet. They responded right away and connected us to high-speed internet. Our big day was incredible because it felt like mom was there.
ExploreNet. Connect to what matters.
So good.
Let me show you why. Our growers, they select the beans. Not as easy as it seems. This one's perfect, that one too. So many great beans to brew.
Premium Arabica.
Ship them off to Canada.
Arrive at our roastery. Sorting, roasting every bean. Taste test each cup.
Coffee masters give thumbs up.
Handcraft fresh brew.
Spreading joy is what we do.
From bean to cup, that is how we brew it up.
Cool. How are you making donuts?
I have a hard time getting back into that type of life. Baseball.
Yeah.
Then I went to my vet doctor. I have a hard time transitioning back into it.
You know, one thing I'll never miss is 100 innings.
Leading on for your HarbourCats, second baseman from the University of Texas, number 2, Tanner Dady.
On we go to the home half of the eighth, and it's another position player on the mound for the lefties. It's going to be Gavin Rourke on the mound as he moves from center field onto the pitcher's bump to try to get through this bottom of the eighth inning. Good start there with an 82-mile-per-hour fastball that was cut on and missed by Tanner Haney. No balls, one strike. Rourke set for the pitch to Tanner Haney. Soft liner to second base. Altamari makes the catch, and that's the first out. HarbourCats will send the bottom third of their order to the plate with Haney, Schindel, and Sharp. So that's the three that will face Gavin Rourke now on the hill. Well, let's now take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard here today in the West Coast League with the final day of action in the regular season here in 2019. HarbourCats with the 6-0 lead here on Port Angeles in the eighth inning. There are two other games kind of just underway, started at 3 o'clock local time here in the West Coast. 1-0 pitch up high there to Schindel. It's 2-0. So no score between Corvallis and Wenatchee in the top of the second inning. Wenatchee obviously trying to win that game to go into the playoffs and the home game for them against the HarbourCats on Tuesday, coming off of a win. Schindel out to shallow center field. This is going to be caught by Rosenberg, backing up into center, and there's two away. Other game that just started, Ridgefield leads Bend 1-0 in the second inning. And then three more games coming up later at 5:05. The Portland Pickles host the Cowlitz Black Bears. And at 6:05, the Kelowna Falcons host the Bellingham Bells. And at 7:05, the Yakima Valley Pippins and Walla Walla Suites will officially wrap up the 2019 West Coast League regular season. This is Jaden Cull at the plate. And this will be officially his fifth game in the regular season, making him eligible to play in the playoffs for the HarbourCats. There's a good breaking ball from Rourke on the outside corner. Some of the fans, though, not convinced that was a strike. It did kind of come back towards the outer half of the plate, and ruled strike one. Oh, one pitch. Another strike, it's nothing and two. Well, the Corvallis Knights did yesterday break the HarbourCats record that they set back in 2016 when the HarbourCats went 40-14, best season-long record ever in the West Coast League. But the Knights broke it yesterday. They are now overall on the season 41-12 with one more game to play. Cull is going to be out at first, and that ends the inning. On we go to the top of the ninth. One more half inning to go in the regular season here in 2019.
All right, guys, we got some birthdays in the house. We have an anniversary. Sharon and Adrian Homestead, 18 years happy. Happy birthday to Luke, who is 11. Happy birthday to our designated hitter today, Tyson Hayes. Birthday
to Bill Rose and a happy 91st birthday to Peter Thompson, who has never missed the HarbourCats day. Yeah, I'm like, I'll just, because I couldn't really pinch run, I'm
sorry, I'll just put it in
The office will be open until 5 o'clock today. You need to get your playoff tickets. Also, the merchandise booth is going to be open till after the game, so you can still get your merchandise. And we set a new WCL hit record in a season. Previous record 578, we are now at 581. Now pitching for your HarbourCats, number 55, Hunter Olin.
Barry's got something in his car.
Leading off with the lefties, catcher number 9, Tommy Takeuchi.
We go to the ninth, and Hunter Olin is on the hill for Victoria to try to get three more outs and wrap up this win for Victoria. It is Olin, who is 1-0 with a 2.57 ERA from Boise State. This is his third appearance of the summer. Tommy Takeuchi, the catcher, at the plate. It'll be Takeuchi, Quinton, and Sear for Port Angeles. Swing and a miss. Nothing in two. Well, Olin, again, has the 2.57 ERA. He's been very good since his arrival from Boise State. Allowed four hits and four walks in seven innings. 0-2. Ground ball towards first. And Liam Balance takes it unassisted to the bag for the first out. Well, Jaden Cull has stayed in the game to do the catching here in the top of the ninth inning. Just at the tail end of the last inning, I was mentioning that the Corvallis Knights now own the best season-long record in the West Coast League with a 41-12 record. They have a chance to go 42-12 if they win today. But either way, they broke the HarbourCats mark of 40-14. But the HarbourCats were very close to equaling their record, because assuming they can get two more outs here, they'll finish the year at 39-15, which is still an excellent regular season for Victoria. First pitch strike there to J.J. Valencia. On the ground towards Balance, I should say. Nice diving stop and a flip to Olin for the out. There's two away. Well, one more out needed for the HarbourCats to call it a regular season. Then they'll get ready for the trip. They'll leave tomorrow to go up to Wenatchee and get ready for Tuesday's game one. HarbourCats have had a great season to date. Regular season has gone just about as well as they could have drawn it up. But with all that said, job's not done. And the HarbourCats know that the most important games of the year are still to come in the playoffs. We'll have it for you on Tuesday night on Facebook Live on the HarbourCats Facebook page for game one. Then we'll be back on Go Live broadcasts on Wednesday night for game two, and if necessary, game three as well on Thursday. One ball and one strike here to Dylan Sear. He is all that stands in the way between the HarbourCats and a sweep of the lefties this weekend. There's a strike on the outside corner, 1-2. And Olin and the HarbourCats are one good pitch away. Fans can sense it here at the park. They're making some noise. Olin looks in. Here comes the 1-2. Swing and a miss. He got him. Sears strikes out. Olin with a 1-2-3 top of the ninth. And the HarbourCats complete the sweep of the lefties this weekend and put a wrap on their 2019 West Coast League regular season. They finish 39-15, they win the division in both the first and second halves of the North Division standings. And now they will head on the road for game one of the North Division series on Tuesday against the Wenatchee Apple Sox before coming home on Wednesday and, if necessary, Thursday for games two and three. We will look forward to that. Playoff baseball, always a fun time of year, and we can't wait to get it started Tuesday. But for now, thanks for joining us all regular season long on Shaw Spotlight and on Go Live Broadcast. On behalf of Chris Jaycox, our producer, and our great camera crew here at Wilson's Group Stadium, my name is Mike Edwards, saying good afternoon and have a great rest of your Sunday from Victoria.